Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs module discussing how ADC manufacturers measure and specify datasheet noise parameters. In a previous Precision Labs module covering the types of ADC noise, we discussed the two types of noise intrinsic to ADCs, where this noise comes from, and what it looks like in both the time and frequency domains. This module will expand upon that knowledge by covering how ADC noise is measured and characterized, the various noise parameters found in ADC datasheets, the difference between relative and absolute noise parameters, and how each parameter type affects lower versus higher resolution ADCs. Ultimately, this presentation has two goals. First, to be able to help you understand and interpret ADC datasheet noise plots and specifications, and second, to motivate you to analyze both ADC and system performance in terms of input-referred noise whenever possible. In a subsequent presentation, we'll take this information and apply it to a design example that compares noise analysis using different parameters as well as describes how to use this information to choose an ADC for your application. To motivate why this discussion is important, let's attempt to choose an ADC for some arbitrary application. For example, here's a typical question we might get from a system designer when they are ready to choose an ADC. In my end equipment, I have determined our noise target is 150 nanovolts. The input range is 0 to 10 millivolts, and we need to sample at 50 samples per second. This requires approximately 16 bits of resolution. Does that mean I can use a 16-bit ADC for my application? If you just needed 16 bits of resolution from an ADC, it would be difficult, but possible, to get this from a 16-bit ADC. However, you absolutely could not use a 16-bit ADC for this system due to the additional low noise and small input range requirements, though it's not always clear why this is the case. One common system design challenge is correlating your requirements to the information found in an ADC's datasheet. To mitigate this challenge, it's important to understand how ADC manufacturers measure and specify ADC noise, as well as know the different ADC noise parameters and their derivations. This knowledge will equip you to confidently read an ADC's datasheet, compare this information to your system's specifications, and confirm it is the right device for your design. There are two methods ADC manufacturers use to measure ADC noise. The first method involves applying a sine wave with a specific amplitude and frequency to report how the ADC quantizes this signal. We will use this method primarily for SAR and wideband delta sigma ADCs where AC performance is critical. Both single-ended and differential input configurations are shown on the left. Also, the test input signals can be referenced to some voltage other than ground, such as mid-supply, as long as the ADC can support this configuration. The second noise measurement test involves applying a DC input to the ADC to measure intrinsic ADC noise. Lower resolution SAR ADCs typically use the single-ended DC input method, as higher resolution SAR and most delta sigma ADCs offer differential inputs. This specific measurement method employs a small DC offset or a mid-supply voltage as a test input and does not have to be ground referenced if the ADC can tolerate pseudo-differential signals. The measured results include some reference noise due to the non-zero input, though usually the ADC's noise is comparatively larger. You can watch the Precision Labs video on the effects of reference noise on ADC performance to learn more about this topic. For differential ADCs, the device's inputs are typically shorted together to mid-supply. With a 0-volt input, no reference noise is present in the measurement. Therefore, the input short variation of the DC input test provides the purest measurement of an ADC's intrinsic noise. Higher resolution ADCs primarily use this method since low noise performance is critical. Let's take a look at an ADC that includes both sine wave input and DC input measurements to better understand how noise is represented in an ADC's datasheet. The plots shown here graphically represent the noise measured using the methods on the previous slide. These specific plots are from the ADS127L01's datasheet, a 24-bit, 512 kilosamples per second wideband delta sigma ADC with a flat passband digital filter. Therefore, we use the sine wave input test to characterize this ADC's noise and report it graphically using the FFT on the left. We report the amplitude of three characteristics from the FFT: the signal, highlighted in green, the noise, highlighted in red, and the distortion, highlighted in purple. Using these three characteristics, we are able to determine common noise metrics including signal-to-noise ratio, or SNR, total harmonic distortion, or THD, and SINAD, or signal-to-noise plus distortion ratio. The ADS-127L01's low noise allows it to be used in low-speed DC precision applications as well. As a result, this ADC's datasheet also includes a histogram of the output noise with shorted inputs, shown on the right. With a 0-volt DC signal applied to the input, the histogram characterizes the ADC's intrinsic noise. As was discussed in the previous module introducing types of ADC noise, the ADS-127L01's high resolution yields a very small LSB size such that thermal noise dominates. Thermal noise's broadband frequency spectrum results in the Gaussian output code distribution shown here. This datasheet's standard deviation is the ADC's RMS noise, represented by the blue lines on the histogram. One standard deviation represents 68% of the dataset, and is effectively the typical noise value you can expect. Comparatively, 4 to 6 standard deviations, the exact multiplier depends on the ADC's noise distribution, represents the peak-to-peak voltage noise. 6 standard deviations represents 99.7% of the dataset and is effectively a maximum noise value. While it is true that peak-to-peak noise can fall outside these limits, it is statistically unlikely and impractical to consider. You can learn more about why this is true in the Precision Labs module on the statistics behind error analysis. Now that you can identify and interpret ADC noise plots in an ADC's datasheet, let's consider how we use this information to calculate ADC noise parameters. Shown here are the most common noise parameters found in an ADC's datasheet, as well as their definitions and equations. While this table contains a lot of information, there are a few key takeaways you should consider. First, noise parameters generally describe either AC or DC performance. We introduced SNR, THD, and SINAD on the previous slide, as well as discussed how these parameters are derived from an FFT as a result of the input sine wave test. One important point captured in this table is that these equations always use the RMS signal and noise, not peak to peak. Therefore, you must make sure to convert your signal and noise values if they are not already in this form. Also, ENOB, or effective number of bits, is an AC performance specification you might see in an ADC's datasheet and is derived from SINAD. ENOB is a figure of merit defined as an ADC's actual resolution under a given set of conditions, as opposed to its ideal resolution. Comparatively, effective resolution, noise-free resolution, and noise-free count represent different ways of reporting DC noise performance. We derive these noise parameters from a histogram via the DC input test. You can see that effective resolution is relative to the ADC's RMS noise, while noise-free resolution is relative to an ADC's peak-to-peak noise. In that context, effective resolution is similar to an ADC's typical dynamic range, while noise-free resolution describes an ADC's maximum dynamic range under the given conditions. In both cases, the full-scale range is a raw value, not RMS or peak-to-peak as it is with the AC parameters. It is also worth noting here that many engineers use the terms ENOB and effective resolution synonymously to describe an ADC's DC performance. However, unlike effective resolution, ENOB is purely a dynamic performance specification derived from SINAD and is not meant to convey DC performance. These terms will be used accordingly throughout the rest of this presentation. Finally, an important characteristic of all of the calculated parameters highlighted here is that they involve some ratio of values. These are referred to as relative parameters. As the name implies, these parameters provide a noise performance metric relative to some absolute value, usually the input signal or the full-scale range. The next few slides will examine this concept in more detail. To understand what a relative parameter is and why it matters, let's revisit the ADS127L01's FFT shown earlier in this presentation. We had discussed the importance of the input signal frequency and amplitude in general, but we didn't look at the actual values of these specifications in detail. In particular, this plot uses an input signal at negative 0.5 dB relative to full scale, where the full scale is 2.5 volts. If you look at the SNR values in the ADS127L01's datasheet shown here on the right of the screen, you'll find that using this input signal in these ADC settings, you can expect a typical SNR of 104.4 dB. However, if you instead choose a different full-scale voltage or input signal amplitude, you won't be able to achieve datasheet performance even if all of the other input conditions are identical. As an example, notice that the table also includes SNR values characterized at a 3-volt reference voltage. Compared to the 2.5 volt reference voltage, you can expect a small increase in SNR even when all other conditions are equal. For our specific case, the 0.5 volt increase in reference voltage boosts SNR performance to 105.8 dB, or an increase of 1.4 dB. You can see this effect with DC noise parameters as well. Shown here is the ADS127L01's noise histogram, as well as part of its effective resolution table. Recall that effective resolution is calculated using the RMS noise and is relative to the ADC's full-scale range. This equation is restated here for reference. Therefore, similar to the SNR example we just looked at, using a different reference voltage changes the device's achievable dynamic range, since full-scale range depends on the ADC's reference voltage. However, unlike the SNR example that used a non-zero input, the differential DC input test used to characterize the ADS127L01 employed a shorted input, 0-volt signal. Since this implies 0 bits of effective resolution, most ADC manufacturers instead specify effective resolution assuming the full-scale range is maximized. This choice yields the largest possible ADC dynamic range at those settings, but requires the input signal to equal the full-scale range. If this is not the case for your system, you won't be able to achieve the effective resolution values specified in the datasheet. As an example, if you were operating the ADS127L01 at the conditions in the histogram using a 2.5 volt reference, you could expect 1.41 microvolts of input referred RMS noise and 21.76 bits of effective resolution. But if your application instead used a 1 volt reference voltage, this reduces the full scale range to 2 volts since the ADS127L01's full scale range is equal to plus minus Vref. Reducing the full-scale range reduces the ADC's effective resolution to 20.44 bits at these settings, assuming the RMS noise remains unchanged. We will confirm this assumption on the next slide. You can generalize this effective resolution loss using the formula shown here, where percent utilization is the ratio of the application-specific full-scale range to the full-scale range at which the ADC's noise is characterized. In this case, changing the full-scale range reduced the ADS127L01's effective resolution by more than 1.3 bits. Ultimately, SNR and effective resolution, like most of the noise parameters we've identified so far, are relative. They will always have to be defined in relationship to some absolute value such as reference voltage, making it challenging to compare specs among different ADCs. This might cause you to wonder, is there such a thing as an absolute noise parameter? You may have noticed that we introduced 8 different metrics in the noise parameter table, but have only discussed the 7 calculated parameters so far. The remaining metric, input referred noise, is the only one that is measured directly. As such, it is the only absolute noise parameter on the list, and the one we recommend you use to perform ADC noise analysis whenever possible. Using an absolute parameter allows you to quickly and fairly compare different ADCs across different manufacturers. Absolute parameters also simplify system noise analysis, since datasheet input referred noise levels are often independent of the input signal or reference voltage. While we claim this is true, you may recall that the previous Precision Labs module covering ADC noise types stated that changing an ADC's reference voltage can affect its overall noise since it changes the LSB size. This is true for ADCs where quantization noise dominates. For thermal noise dominant ADCs, reference voltage has little impact on noise performance. To prove this point, shown here is the input referred noise versus reference voltage plot from the ADS127L01's datasheet, the ADC we've been analyzing throughout this presentation. The reference voltage extends from 0.5 volts to 3 volts, representing the minimum and maximum values possible for this device. The maximum change in input referred noise over this span is 0.18 microvolts RMS. Relative to the change in reference voltage, which is 2.5 volts, this variation equates to only 0.072 ppm. In other words, the ADS127L01's noise experiences no significant change with respect to reference voltage, so you can consider this ADC's input referred noise absolute under the given conditions. The crossover point between lower and higher resolution ADCs generally occurs at the 16-bit level. For ADCs with 16-bit or less resolution, reference voltage affects ADC noise levels and should not be considered a true absolute parameter. On the other hand, thermal noise dominates in ADCs with greater than 16 bits of resolution, so changes in reference voltage do not affect noise performance as shown here using the ADS127L01. Unfortunately, most ADCs do not have a noise versus reference voltage plot to verify this claim. Instead, you can look at the more common noise plots discussed throughout this module to confirm this delineation. Shown here are the histograms for three different SAR ADCs, ranging from 12 to 20 bits. Though we will use SAR ADCs for this example, the same analysis applies to any ADC with a histogram, including wideband delta sigmas. On the left, almost all of the 12-bit ADS7044's output codes fall into one bin. Minimal code spread indicates a quantization noise dominant ADC, since the random nature of thermal noise would result in a Gaussian code distribution. Instead, this lower resolution ADC's thermal noise is obscured by quantization noise. Since quantization noise is directly related to LSB size and reference voltage, lower resolution ADC input referred noise is relative. Fortunately, noise is not typically an important design challenge when using lower resolution ADCs, especially compared to solution size, power consumption, and cost. On the right, the 20-bit ADS8900B histogram shows significant code spread and a 2 ppm or 2.1 LSB standard deviation. This indicates a thermal noise dominant ADC since the RMS noise is greater than the LSB size. The histogram's Gaussian code distribution further indicates the random, broadband nature of thermal noise compared to quantization noise. Therefore, you can conclude that the ADS8900B's input referred noise is absolute. Since noise performance at the 20-bit level is critical, using an absolute parameter provides a standard value to compare against other potential noise sources, as well as enables you to easily compare this value against other 20-bit ADCs to determine which one meets all of your system requirements. Finally, at the 16-bit level, you can see elements of both quantization noise and thermal noise. Some code spread exists that might indicate thermal noise, but the standard deviation is still less than plus minus 0.5 LSB. You can also see that one bin clearly dominates, but the absolute frequency of hits in this bucket, around 1,350, is considerably smaller than the 12-bit ADC's frequency, at around 65,000 hits. Taken together, these observations demonstrate that the transition point between a quantization noise and a thermal noise dominant ADC generally occurs at the 16-bit level, as we claimed on the previous slide. For those ADCs that do not include histograms in their datasheets, typically low-speed delta sigmas, you can identify a quantization noise versus thermal noise dominant ADC using a noise table. Shown here are the datasheet noise tables for the 16-bit ADS114S08 and the 24-bit ADS124S08, two low-speed delta sigma ADCs. These devices come from the same product family, and other than their resolutions, are identical. This enables a fair noise performance comparison, shown here in microvolts RMS, and peak-to-peak using a 2.5-volt reference voltage. Note that the 16-bit ADC input referred noise is the same for all data rates at 76.3 microvolts RMS. On the other hand, the 24-bit ADC input referred noise values vary depending on the data rate. Even though both Delta Sigma ADCs benefit from oversampling and noise shaping at the different data rates, the lower resolution ADC exhibits constant noise at any speed, while the higher resolution ADC's noise changes. Why does this occur? Calculating each ADC's respective LSB size helps clarify how this relates to quantization versus thermal noise dominant ADCs. For the 16-bit ADC, the ADC noise equals the LSB size due to the fact that quantization noise dominates in lower resolution ADCs. For this ADC, input referred noise is relative. This allows you to reduce the overall noise by decreasing the reference voltage. For example, a 1.25-volt reference would reduce the ADS114S08's noise to 38.15 microvolts RMS at any data rate and gain equal to 1. On the other hand, the 24-bit ADC's quantization noise is 0.298 microvolts RMS, lower than any value shown in the table on the right. In this case, thermal noise obscures the very low levels of quantization noise. Reducing quantization noise for the 24-bit ADC would have no effect on the overall ADC noise performance, so the ADS124S08's input referred noise is considered absolute. This reiterates the claim that the transition point between a quantization noise and thermal noise dominant ADC generally occurs at the 16-bit level. Moreover, like the 20-bit ADS8900B on the previous slide, the absolute nature of the ADS124S08's input referred noise provides a standard value to compare against other potential noise sources, as well as enables you to easily compare this value against other 24-bit ADCs to determine if they meet all your system requirements. To that end, let's revisit the hypothetical request made at the beginning of this presentation. Even with the same system requirements, it's easier to choose an ADC based on the input referred noise requirements since there is no direct correlation between your system's resolution and an ADC's resolution. Does that mean using a 24-bit ADC to get 16-bit resolution forces you to pay for performance that the device cannot actually provide? No, because 16-bit resolution doesn't necessarily tell you anything about how much of the full-scale range you use, or how finely those bits needed to be resolved. You may only need 16 bits of resolution, but if the minimum input signal is 150 nanovolts, you'll never be able to resolve that with a 16-bit ADC. The true benefit of a high-resolution ADC is the low levels of input referred noise it offers. It does not mean that effective resolution is unimportant, just that it is not the best way to parameterize a system. Now that you better understand how noise is represented in an ADC's datasheet and why input referred noise is the best parameter for noise analysis, the next Precision Labs module applies this information to a practical example so you can choose an ADC for your next design. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content. Question 1. Which of the following parameters would not depend on the maximum applied input signal amplitude? The correct answer is E, input referred noise. All the other parameters are relative in that they are impacted by the signal amplitude, or full-scale range. Question 2, true-false. Reference voltage typically does not impact the input referred noise for low-resolution ADCs. The correct answer is B, false. For low-resolution ADCs, they are often quantization noise dominant. In this case, the ADC reference voltage will impact the input referred noise. On the other hand, the high-resolution devices are usually dominated by thermal noise, so they are not impacted by the reference voltage. Question 3, true-false. The table below is representative of a device that is quantization noise dominated. The correct answer is B, false. If the device was quantization noise limited, the data rate would not impact the total noise, and it would be the same for every data rate. Question 4. A DC input signal is applied to an ADC as shown in the figure below. Is the output histogram indicative of a device that is dominated by thermal noise or quantization noise? The correct answer is B, quantization noise. If this were thermal noise dominant, you would expect to see a Gaussian distribution. In this case, the noise is mostly confined to one code, so the noise is mostly quantization noise.